Yeah, we got it. Earlier we did the count, it just counted 1, also the 0. But when we do sum, it just count the sum 1. Hello guys and welcome back to Coding for Beginners. My name is Omkar and in today's video we'll be having a data analyst interview questions and their answer. So if you're new in the channel, please consider subscribing to it as it will notify you for my next videos. So without any further ado, let's have the video. So let's talk about the agenda of today's video. We'll be having introduction of SQL, then we'll be having fifth and theory interview questions and their answer, and the next we'll be having coding interview questions. The platform on which we are having the interview questions is SQL Practice. Next, I'll talk about the best resources you can plan to be prepared from the interview you're giving. And last, we'll talk about the summary and hence we would end the session. So SQL stands for Structured Query Language. It is a programming language designed for managing and manipulating relational database. So there are the two types of the database. One is relational and one is non-relational. Today's topic of discussion would be on the relational database, as we're talking about structured query language. The structure name itself suggests it's a for a relational. If it's non-SQL, then means it's a non-relational databases. Okay. So now let's start with the first question. What are the different types of SQL commands? So in SQL, we have four types of command. First one is a data definition language. Commands like create, then we have alter or drop, etc. comes under data definition language. Definition means we are defining our database, like create, alter and drop. Next we have data manipulation language, which means we are manipulating a databases. Manipulating means can be select statement, it can be insert statement. Like then we have data control language. Data control language is like a grant, or we have revoke. At the last we have transaction control language, which is commit or a rollback. So you can give these examples to the recruiter which you have given the interview. The question is, what are the primary key and the foreign key? So primary key is a unique identifier for record in the table, and the foreign key is the field in one table that refers to primary key in another table. For example, so this is department table, this is student table. So under student table, the primary key is student ID, and same key is acting as a foreign key in another table because it's a joining on another table. So I hope it gets clear. What are normalization and denormalization? Normalization is the process of organizing data in a database to reduce redundancy and improve data integrity. So two words here very important: reduce redundancy and improve data integrity. Whereas denormalization is a process of adding redundant data to database in order to improve performance. It involves duplicating data across the tables to reduce need for the joins. So in denormalization we will have one table, only one master table, which have all the like orders. Let's take an example of hotel. We have orders, the name of the customer, and all this table will be get in the one inside one table. But whereas in normalization we have different tables, like for orders, let's say for customer, for a delivery boy. So these are the different tables would be get in normalization. But in denormalization we would have duplicate data in one table. So here comes our first question. The question is, show unique birth years from patients and order them by ascending. So here we have selection from patient. The column name which will have the unique birth years is a date, birth date column, and the table name is a patients. So we'll take year from a date, that is a birth date, birth underscore date, and we want unique, so we'll paste here a distinct keyword. Okay, I'll just select this and control enter. So your query does not match expert output. Okay, as yeah, we also want to order them by ascending. So the last thing is order by year, birth, death. Okay, You got it correct. So we have successfully solved the first question. So let's now get at the next question.
Next question we have, what is a joint? What is the difference between the left and the right joint? A joint is a SQL operation that combines rows from the two or more tuple based on the related column between them. So there we have asked for the difference between left and the right joint. Left joint returns all the rows from the left table and matching rows from the right table. Okay. And the right joint returns all the rows from the right table and matching rows from the left table. We will have a little more hands-on on our practical session so that you can understand more. What is the difference between union and union all? Union removes duplicate rows from the result set, whereas union all includes all the rows from the result set even if they are duplicates. So if you want to include duplicates, do union all. If you don't want duplicates, do union. Okay, so take this example. We have table 1 under which we have A, B, C column. Column 1 has A, B, C. Then we have table 2 as D and E. What this column will do by means of union will have A, B, C, D, E, all the distinct numbers. Let's take this example. We have A, B, C and another table we have D, E, D. So D is duplicated here. Okay. If you're doing union all, it will have D 2 times C, D 2 times 4 and 4. Okay. So this is duplicated by means of union all. So this is the difference between union is for distinct and union all will allow duplicates. What is ACID properties in SQL? ACID stands for atomicity, consistency, isolation and durability. So atomicity means either the transaction will happen or not. Consistency, database must be consistent before and after the transaction. Isolation, multiple transactions occur independently without any interference. Durability is the chances of successful transaction occurs even if the system fail occurs. So the system should be durable enough that would handle any mishaps at the system. What is a deadlock? Deadlock occurs when two or more transactions are waiting for each other to release locks on the resources. Let's say we have the resources here as a time node. So these are transaction 1 and this is transaction 2. These two guys are waiting for a job, that is resources. What is OLTP versus what is OLAP? OLTP stands for Online Transaction Processing. It is a type of database where that is optimized for handling high volumes of a transaction in real time. And OLAP stands for Online Analytical Processing. It is a type of database system that is optimized for complex analysis and reporting, such as data mining and forecasting. What is a self join? A self join is a join operation where table is joined to itself based on the related column. It is used to compare rows within the same table. So as you have known, this is the table E and the table E1 and E2 are from the same, but they are having a self join, that is a join on the same table. What is a group by clause versus a having clause? A group by clause in a SQL system that is used to group rows in a table based on a specific column. It often used with the aggregate function to summarize the data. Is a clause in a SQL system that is used to filter the result of group by query based on the specific condition. The filter groups based on the aggregate values. We'll talk more about the group by and having in our practical session.
So here is our next question. Show the province IDs and sum of their height, where the total sum of its patients' height is greater than or equal to 7,000. So I'll just copy province ID from here. Instead of star, we'll use province ID. And then next, we want as a sum of height. So sum of. Okay. Where the total sum of its patients' height is greater than equal to 7,000. So what we'll do, we'll group by a province ID. Okay, and we'll say having sum of their heights is greater than or equal to 7,000. Okay, so we have three province ID like BC, NS, ON. So we have used having and not a where, because where is not for this aggregate function. If I change it from the where, it will show an error. Where syntax error. Okay.
What is CTE? CTE is a temporary named result set that can be referenced within a SQL statement. It is often used to simplify complex queries and improve readability. So it's common table expression. Let's say we have the two tables. So this CTE name, average, price, brand. This CTE name, this table is a CTE body that is exactly content of a CTE, and it is called with width. So width name of the CTE table as the main content of the CTE. Then we are calling as a select c.id, c.brand, c.model and all this stuff from camera C, join on average price brand, where average is the allies of that, and we are saying on c.brand and average.brand. Okay. This is the best example for CTE. We'll talk more about this in the practical session. What is a window function? A window function is a SQL function that performs a calculation across set of rows that are related to current row. It is used to calculate running totals, averages, and the rankings. So aggregate functions are normal functions like sum, averages, whereas a window function is like over, partition, order. So you can see aggregate functions get aggregated on the one single column, whereas a window function keeps it separate on its operation. We'll talk more of these differences in a practical question. What is ETL? In current market scenario, the most of the job focus on the ETL data engineer job or ETL data pipelines of Azure or AWS or GCP. So what is basically ETL is extract, transform, load. Is a process used to extract the data from various sources. We transform it to format suitable for analysis, and then we load the data into database or other databases where we can generate our reporting, the pie charts or the column charts based on that, or current trending or like somewhat like that. What is a case statement? It's a basic question. A case statement is used to perform conditional logic within SQL system. It is the same like other languages like C++, C, Python. So it's a base system. We'll talk more about this in a practical question. What is subquery in SQL? Subquery in SQL is a query within another query. It is also called a nested query or an inner query. So there are two types of query we have. One is a correlated and a no correlated. I have one example for you. Let's say select star from employee, where employee in. So this red statement is a subquery. So what is different between CTE and the subquery? The CTE starts with a width CTE table as, and then we have the content. Okay, but in subquery we don't have any width keyword. We just say in, and again we define the subquery. So this is the basic difference between CTE and the subquery. So in this question we have to show the total amount of male patients and the total amount of female patients in the patient table. Display the two results in the same row. So now let's see what is the expected output. Here we have expected like a male count 2468. Female count 206. Now where to get the genders is from the gender column in the patient table. Okay, so here we have to use a case statement. Okay, so how to use it? We'll have first a count. Under count we'll say a case when. Case when gender equals, this is string, so single quotes, then else 0 and we will name it as outside the case as a male underscore count. Select statement would be the same, so I'll just copy this one and yeah, I think it should work fine. Your query does not match expected output, so you got it. So you have to do a sum rather than count. Now let's check with this. Yeah, we got it. Earlier we did the count, it just counted 1, also the 0, but when we do sum, it just count the sum 1. Okay, so that's the difference between aggregate function called sum and the count. So there are the number of resources you can go online and prepare on it. The first resources, the best resource is a LeetCode. LeetCode has a many good questions on SQL where you can go and practice on it. I think it has some 50 or 55 odd questions free for available for SQL. You don't have to pay anything. You just go practice. It also has some solutions on it. You can go and check their solution as well. The next resource is very good, is College W3 Schools. It has a website. So it is a website where we have text-based tutorials. You don't have to watch any video on that. So it's a very easy to learn and do fast. The another resource is SQL Practice. It is completely for practice. It also has some few of the tutorials, but it's mostly for the practice platform. It has a inbuilt databases. So you just have to go and make the query. So I hope this video was helpful for you. If please like this video.
If you're new in the channel, please consider subscribing to it as it will notify you for my next new videos. So that's all it for today, guys. Hope to see you in the next video. Bye.